An investigation is underway into how negative comments about President Trump were printed in the Brainerd High School yearbook.
One of those comments could be considered a threat. Now the school district and the community want to know how this happened. This story is also getting attention across the country. Even actor Scott Baio tweeting about it and tagging President Trump and the FBI. We'll have a poll running during our report so you can weigh in. Just go to care11.com/vote now. Care11's Zach Lashway spent the day in Brainerd. There's no shortage of opinions on this controversy. He's there live tonight with our top story.
Randy, tensions were very high throughout the day. Students telling me the girl who was quoted in the yearbook has been receiving hate mail. Now, earlier this afternoon, students and parents gathered here on this corner. We are across from the high school to voice their frustration and concerns with the yearbook spread.
Threatening the president is a crime.
That threat found in the Brainerd High School's 2017 yearbook.
Not happy with what was posted in the school yearbook publication.
Tonight is causing uproar throughout the Brainerd community and the nation.
You kids just don't know what's going on anymore.
The statement found on page 11 reads, quote, "I would like to behead him. I do not like him," end of quote. This is in response to the question, Trump 2017 through 2020, how do you feel about him?
They should have brains enough not to publish something like that. It's not about her. It's not right. Democrat. It's not Republican. It's about hate.
And that's not the only comment that's become controversial.
It's so hard to want to repeat what was said on 11, but on 35, it was this was in regards to Trump thinking rapists were okay.
Ultimately, the school is responsible for the publication. The bottom line is it was posted. It is promoting violence. It is not okay. And someone needs to answer with a solution.
In a statement, the school said in part, quote, "The district does not support or otherwise endorse any disrespectful or politically based statements that are in the yearbook and apologizes for the statements that were included," end of quote. They go on to say they are investigating.
I think that the advisor of the yearbook definitely needs to be held accountable. I don't think this should have went to press without the superintendent checking it first, the principal checking it first. I think it should have went through all of those channels before it finally hit the press.
For the students.
It does definitely cross the line of free speech when you make threats towards somebody's safety. Threatened.
But they want you to know.
I don't think that our school is, you know, a bad school or...
I reached out to the school several times throughout the day. I have not heard back from them yet. I also reached out to the publisher of the yearbook, Jostens, to see where this editorial process stops. They say that they basically just print the books. The editorial process ends inside the school. They did say they have a discussion going on with the school district to see what they're going to do. One option is to print stickers that basically cover that page. That would be free of cost for the students. Julian, Randy?
Well, I do hope we get some answers from the school, though, because that seems to be a serious lack of good judgment in this case. Thank you, Zach.